So first, I want to thank you all for over 5,000 subscribers. Like, so this is the first tutorial. It's really long, like almost 50 minutes. And brace yourself. It's for all of you who think you need a big set of Prismacolor to create a portrait. You don't need it. You really don't. Just follow this tutorial. You see all my mistakes, all the corrections I made. I didn't speed it up as much as my last tutorial, so it will be much easier to follow. This is the paper I use. Don't forget the electric sharpener. It's amazing. Electric eraser. I bought a new one from Createx. It's really good. Good luck for me and my kitty.
So here you go, the 12th set. I picked it out from my 150 set. And here is the sketch. Yes, here's the sketch. I made of Emma Watson. And this paper is the paper I'm going to use as a palette. And my reference picture is right here. I will use this reference picture to next to the palette to show you how to blend. So we can see how close the colors get to the photo. For your information, next are all the numbers and names of the colors from the 12 set. I like to start with the eyes before I start with the skin. For her brown eyes, we have Sienna Brown and dark brown and black and a little bit of canary yellow and white. So we're going to mix. We start with dark brown. Add the sienna brown. I try mixing them together. I only use the black to see how it will turn out with the pupil. Just a little bit of canary yellow. Because it's very bright and I keep mixing the colors I named until I'm satisfied. Sometimes I blend with white and after that I add another layer with a bit of sienna brown and dark brown. You don't have to do this, it's not necessary, but sometimes it gives a certain glow to the eye. And okay, let's see it up close. It looks natural. As you can see, it's good to use. So we start with the sienna brown and softly draw on the paper. Make small circles like this. This is important for blending. It will look more smooth. So a soft touch with canary yellow. Now we go to dark brown. Quick Sharpie, still the best thing for my Prismas, is this electric sharpener. I use the dark brown on the outer circle and around the iris. So you don't want to know how I'm drawing and videotaping this video at the same time. It's super weird. Okay, well, we go back to the iris with black, of course. And I don't need to press hard at first, just press as soft as possible. So if you do anything wrong, it's easier to correct it. So a layer of dark brown. And just a little bit of black again. I will do the eyelashes. And this is something you shouldn't do. But I can't stop myself. Just wait with the eyelashes until you start with the skin color. So I will use black and dark brown around the iris and outer circle and for contouring the eyes. And white to color the white part of the eye. And just mix it a bit with the black so it makes a bit of a shadowy effect. So let's start with the next eye. Using Sienna Brown, softly color it on paper. Canary yellow, just a little bit. And I will check it again with the reference picture. So maybe it needs a little bit of orange. This is orange and Sienna Brown mixing on the palette. Then make another layer of dark with dark brown. See it up close. Okay, we put orange in the mix, a bit on the other eye too. And dark brown for the outer lines and around the iris and just below the eyelashes. Sienna brown and dark brown. Just color it until you're satisfied. Here's the black for the the pupil and outer circle and upper eyelashes. Again, wait with the eyelashes. And just give it more contour. I decided not to use white as a layer, so I just keep blending with Sienna Brown and dark brown to get a more natural flow from the pupil. And Sienna Brown, Canary Yellow, Orange, Black, make a bit of shadow under the upper eyelid. White, black. Now I'm using black gently over the eyebrows. Don't press hard. And dark brown. I also use dark brown for the upper eyelids and contouring the eyes. And to add a bit of shadow. And after this, we are going to start with the skin. So, Sienna Brown around the eye. Orange, just keep it light and don't press hard. Sienna Brown again. Yellow. Crimson Red. And dark brown for the darker parts. And blend it with white. Here you can press hard on the paper or else it won't blend. Adding Sienna Brown along the nose and the eye. And dark brown and a little bit of black, adding more depth and shadow. Orange. Yellow. Sienna Brown. Yellow. Dark brown. Mix for the shadowy part just around the face and eyes using dark brown and violet. There's also a little violet around the eye, so I will add that later. First, let's get the right color mix for the cheek. Sienna brown, orange, crimson red, canary yellow, and blend it with white. I add another layer with crimson red and I blend with white again. For the skin, we need orange, yellow, sienna brown, and blend it with white. So we need the following colors: violet around the eyes, Blend it with white, press hard to mix. And add some orange and blend it with white again. Here I fixed the eyelashes with black and white. So this is the reason to wait with the eyelashes, as I mentioned before. I add eyelashes below. Okay, sienna brown around the eye, along the nose, and along the cheek and face to create shadow. And next, violet and dark brown along her face to create shadow. And the white marking along her face. For her cheek, crimson red, orange, sienna brown, canary yellow, and blend it with white. So next thing I'll do is add another layer with sienna brown. Orange, crimson red, and blend with white. The eyes again. Softly mark the dark parts of the nose and dark brown over the black and adding shadow. And lightly add with sienna brown, orange, crimson red, violet, dark brown, canary yellow, sienna brown again, and blend it with white. I want to see the result first before I go any further. So softly add sienna brown, orange, dark brown, yellow, and blend it with white. And here I just keep on adding layers with these colors. Including crimson red, by the way, and I mix it until I'm satisfied. Okay, add to the forehead sienna brown, orange, sienna brown again, yellow, and I add shadow with dark brown and violet. So here I add crimson red, a little bit of black over the shadowy part, and I mix it with white. And I keep blending and adding sienna brown, orange, and dark brown. Until I just continue with the forehead using orange, sienna brown, yellow, crimson red, and blend it with white. And I keep using these colors. Here I add this combination to the rest of the forehead, that includes the colors orange, sienna brown, yellow, and crimson red, and finish with the white blending. Between the eyebrows it's a bit darker, less brightened, so I add a bit of orange and a bit more sienna brown to fix it. So next is above the eyebrows. It's a bit brighter. So the next thing is I'll add a white layer above it right here, and then add a layer of orange and blend it with white again. The forehead does not look very smooth, so I see that I need to make smaller circles while adding layers. So when we blend it with white, it will be more smooth. So right now I just keep on blending with white, and after that I just add another layer. And just keep in mind that while adding more layers with the colors, don't press hard. Just press very softly on the paper and just only press hard with the white to blend. So as you can see, it's getting more smooth now. So I keep on blending with white and add the light reflections on the forehead. And I just go back and forth on the drawing because I could never stay on one part of the drawing. When I see something that needs correction, I just do it. So, as you can see, I'm everywhere. So the ridge between the nose and the eyebrows and the forehead, it's not smooth. So I'll fix it with sienna brown, crimson red, and orange, and finish with blending with white. And while I'm working with the white, I will also add some bright parts on the nose. I mix the dark part on the right with dark brown, violet, orange, yellow, sienna brown, and mix it with white. Looking up close. Okay. Well, let's try it out. Sienna brown, violet, sienna brown, orange, dark brown, yellow and white. So blend it well. And I add another layer with orange, dark brown, and end up with white blending again. And I just keep on layering with these colors until it's dark enough and smooth enough. So here I'm blending the forehead. And finally, I move on with sienna brown, dark brown, and black around the eyes. And for the skin around the eyes, I use sienna brown, orange, crimson red, yellow, and violet for the shadow, of course. And I blend it with white. For the cheek, I use orange, yellow, sienna brown, and I blend it with white. And I keep on adding layers until I'm satisfied. So to add more shadow around the eyes, I will use dark brown. And here I press a bit harder. And I'm starting with the blush on the cheeks with crimson red and blend it with white.
Sienna brown. Dark brown. Adding shadow on the cheek and on the forehead, on the side. And violet. And I just got aware that I'm using my finger sometimes to smooth things out, as you can see. So I keep adding shadow with dark brown. And I also use orange and blend it with white until I'm satisfied. Now I get to the under eyelid using Sienna Brown Orange. And Sienna Brown again. A little bit of crimson red. And blend it with white. So I'm fixing the skin of the upper eyelid by blending orange with white, and I fix the details above the eye with dark brown and black. And I also add shadow with dark brown under the eye and blend it with white, and also add some light parts. So I add the upper eyelid again and with dark brown and black, and I'm contouring the eyes and fixing the eyelashes. Here I add more shadow under the eye with dark brown, orange, crimson red, and violet. And I mix it up with white and sienna brown. And I fix the eyelashes and the eye with black and white. Now, I use dark brown for adding shadow from the eye to the eyebrow, and I blend it with white, and finally I start with the eyebrows with dark brown, black, and sienna brown. Here's the black. And here's the sienna brown. Moving on to the skin. With sienna brown, around the nose and the jawline. Add some crimson red, especially for the blush on the cheeks. And orange. In brown, in yellow, and blend it with white. Do you notice that I use the yellow especially on the brighter parts on her face? So it gives an extra effect. So I add violet for the shadow and over it with orange. Violet again. Yellow. Sienna brown. Little bit of crimson red. And I finish with the blending. So I'm not content when I'm done, so I will add another layer with orange, yellow, sienna brown, and I just blend it again until I'm satisfied. I add dark brown to add more shadow and blend it out with white, of course, and some more crimson red to create more blush on the cheeks. And blend with white, of course, and softly add orange, sienna brown and crimson red between the nose and lips. So here's sienna brown. Here's orange again, and crimson red, and of course blended with white. And I will also add more light parts to the face. So I have two whites, so I don't have to sharpen it that often. I can work faster. So here I add another layer with sienna brown and crimson red, and I blend it with white. And I just keep on adding layers until it's smooth. And now I add more shadow to the nose with sienna brown, dark brown, and crimson red. And I blend it out with white. And I will retouch the nose with dark brown and white and sienna brown. Here's dark brown and white, and here's sienna brown. And I add more shadow. Now I add shadow to the left eye with dark brown. And I fix the eyes and brows with black. So I erase the graphite lines for the lips so it doesn't mix with the color pencils. And I start with the chin with sienna brown. So add orange to soft small circles and crimson red. I leave the in the middle, I leave it lighter because that's a bright part on the face. That's why I put yellow and white for blending. And I add another layer of sienna brown to blend out the gap. So it's gone. And I keep on blending. And the cheek on the left is a bit too red, so I blend it with white to make it lighter. So when I'm done, I will add another layer, and it will be with orange and dark brown and sienna brown. After this, as you can see, the gap is still not fixed on the right, so I just keep on adding layers. So this is sienna brown, and I start blending all over again. I'll finish the eyebrows with dark brown, sienna brown, and black. Now I'm using dark brown, and this is black, and sienna brown. So use sienna brown on the upper side of the eyebrow, and black especially on the lower side of the eyebrow, and in between just dark brown, just mix it together. So I'll add shadow below the jawline with dark brown, sienna brown, and violet. This is dark brown. And then sienna brown. Violet. And orange. So I'm also going to the lighter parts of her neck with orange, canary yellow, and sienna brown. So lightly add sienna brown further on her neck and create a bit of shadow. I'm just drawing very small, soft circles, and I'll add the orange. And sienna brown again, just a bit. And yellow. Crimson red. And dark brown. And with the dark brown, I create darker and lighter parts in the neck. And white for blending. And I just keep adding layers until it's right. And oh, I almost forgot, somewhere I also use a bit of crimson red. And I'll add I will add more dark brown under the shadowy part under the jawline and chin. So it will pop out more on paper. So as you can see, I'm just very careful with the first layer, and I just keep adding layers until it's right. It's better just to not to do too much, instead of doing too much and have to erase it. So so just try it out and keep adding layers until you see that it's it looks good. And keep mixing with white, of course. So I mix the lips on the palette with orange, crimson red, sienna brown, and blend it with white until it looks good. Okay, look up close. And we start with orange. Soft circles on the surface. And adding sienna brown to the darker parts. And I will finish it with crimson red and white blending, of course, and I'm not done with the lips. I will finish them later, so this is just the first layer. So I'm correcting the neckline with dark brown black and an eraser. And I will start with the ear, but with erasing the graphite line, and finally to add some orange. Tracing the lines. And next add sienna brown to the darker parts of the ear. As you can see, I'm very careful, so it's going to be more layers. And a bit of crimson red, yellow, and blend with white. So now I'm starting with another layers with sienna brown and dark brown. And orange, crimson red, and blend it with white again. So this is dark brown, orange, and crimson red, and white blending. Now for the darker parts, add violet. And dark brown. And finish with blending. And I will also work a little bit on her earring with black, dark brown, and white. is black and dark brown. And doing some more on the ear. And I just keep on adding more layers with the orange and sienna brown, dark brown, red and yellow. And don't forget to blend with the white. Crimson red, violet, orange, crimson red again, and blend it with white. And with the white and the crimson red, I will also add more details to the lips. This is right here. No, with the white. Like this. So, next is making more shadow with the violet and dark brown. The violet and dark brown mix very well together. So here's dark brown. And blend it with the white. And now I add white to the teeth, and I will also contour the teeth with black and add a bit of shadow and mix it with the white. And I just smooth it all out around the lips. So I'm going to the ear and the hair next, with just a little bit of retouching the ear and the eyes with the dark brown and white. And now with the dark brown, I will add some shadow and hair strokes. And I just keep on making strokes in the direction the hair goes. And you see me using white in between, that's because of the earring, but we will go to it later. So here's dark brown making strokes. So I only use the dark brown for the very dark parts of the hair. And press a bit harder. And on the light parts, I just try to press as light as possible. So, you know, in the middle, it's lighter. So now I go with to black, adding more shadow in the hair. And just and sienna brown, just mix it up together so it doesn't look too dark. And now adding more strokes with the sienna brown. Oh, and fixing the skin tone where the hair splits with orange, sienna brown and white. I just keep using sienna brown, dark brown, black and white to add details. Sienna brown, adding more strokes to the hair. And soft strokes with canary yellow. And for the darker parts, I mix the dark brown with the black. And I go darker with the black, adding more details. And dark brown will be mixed with the sienna brown. Well, going back to black, going darker and adding more details and strokes. And finally finish with the sienna brown and the dark brown, and in the middle of the hair where the light falls on it, will be fixed with the white to get a shiny effect. So, quick background for the finishing touch using violet, violet blue, black, dark brown, white, canary yellow, apple green, sienna brown and orange. So now you know what you can achieve with the 12 set of Prismacolor.